I'm Hayley Leggs here for Bloodstock Radio at Bloodstock Festival 2013. Well, I just met this lovely young man. I can't remember your name, I'm afraid.
My name's Mitchel Emms.
And you say you got spotted for this because you were on The Voice earlier this year.
Yeah, I kind of sold my soul to the BBC, so I feel kind of guilty about it, but I'm quite proud of being the only rock guy to go on the show, so thinking how far I got, so really proud of what I did, actually. So.
I've not actually seen it before. What's the deal with The Voice?
Basically, it's the idea that it's all meant to be about The Voice, is that the coaches, when you do your audition, they don't see what you look like. All they do is they got their kind of chairs turned, so they'll push their buzzer to turn around if they like you, and then they'll see what you look like, and then after that, it does all start to become about your image and what you know you do. But initially, it's meant to be about The Voice. So.
And what's your vocal style?
Vocal styles, I wouldn't define it as something kind of specific. It's more just, I do tend to have kind of a gravel to my voice, but I try and keep it nice and sweet in certain areas. So I guess my favorite vocalist, like Lane Staley, for example, from Alice in Chains. Kind of like that, but less, you know what I mean? So
more like the new singer of Alice in Chains.
Yeah, kind of, yeah.
So from that, was you spotted by the Bloodstock Festival people?
Well, I was in bands previously, and we'd done competitions, we'd done the Metal to the Masses loads of times to actually play Bloodstock. So Simon was aware of my existence by the time the Voice kicked off, and I was surprised at the amount of support I had from Simon and the Bloodstock community for what I was doing. You know, but I'm not surprised because, you know, metalheads are some of the most open-minded people I know. So basically, as soon as I was off the show, he contacted and said, I've got a slot for you on the Jägermeister stage, would you like to come here and perform? So I was like, yeah, go for it. But I didn't want to come here and just stand with an acoustic guitar and be really boring, you know? Just be like,
it's hard not to be boring with just an acoustic guitar, isn't it? What do you plan on doing then?
Well, I've got a band helping me out. They played last year, and I'm good friends with them. They played the New Blood stage and the Jäger stage. They're called 1,000 Enemies, who will be joining me on stage for the set. And we're just going to have a shitload of fun. It's going to be really great.
Cool. So what else have you got lined up after Bloodstock?
After Bloodstock, it's mainly focusing on my own band. I put a band together during filming for The Voice based on an album that I wrote and recorded from my bedroom. And I put the band together, and it's kind of more alternative rock sort of stuff. So probably more the sort of thing you'd hear at Reading and Leeds, I guess. But
Boo, yes.
Yeah. But yeah, the band's called Mr. Nothing, and that's not MR Nothing, because that looks really crap. But full on Mr. Nothing with no gap in it. But sorry, that sounds like really specific. Like it must be spelt this way. But
it's okay. It's okay.
I try.
At least you spelt it properly. Okay, that's the main thing. I like your necklace, by the way.
Thank you. I got this. I wear it ironically. I'm not religious, but that's like the weirdest thing to say. But yeah.
He's probably like set on fire at the moment you stepped in here if you were too religious. No. Okay, well, thank you very much. Good luck with your show later on.
Thanks.
Enjoy.
Cheers.